yourselves. Ball thrown up in the air, a bit of dip. Narayan's eyes lit up. He went to smash it out of Abu Dhabi. Played all round it, the ball thudded into the stumps.
Nasser Hussain really flighted. Have a look at that. Yeah, normally fires the ball in flat. Clever bowling.
And this one's clubbed away on the leg side. Oh, a nice bit of fielding. Oh, is this going to be a run out chance as well? Ah, this one's been smashed away. It's going to go all the way. All the way out to the bank for six.
He's been doing this for Afghanistan for the best part of 10 or 12 years. Boom, plenty of power. Again, it's tossed up by Nasser. It's risky bowling, it really is. Shazzy doesn't need a second invite.
Yeah. Oh, but this one's gone straight up in the air. Is it going to be two wickets in the over? It is! Brilliant from Hussain, wasn't scared about being hit for six again, took the pace off the ball again, threw it up, Shazad went for the big hit, top edge, straight in the air, and well caught at square leg.
Wow, brilliant captaincy from Nasser Hussain himself to take the new ball. Not afraid to give it a bit of flight. Shazad, well, he pumped him into the stand the previous. This is a good catch, really good catch. It looks easy into the night sky, and Nasser Hussain, the prince from Dhaka.
Shower Dre is getting blocked up quicker than you. Oh, that's got to be out! Brilliant start from Ansari. He bowls like Malinga. He's pitched it full. There's a bit of swing as well. And the big wicket of Kieran Pollard playing all round it. Surprised, shocked by the delivery. Sprack in front. Oh dear, dear oh dear. Is there an injury? Someone that seems to be down here. Oh dear, who is that? Someone took her. Oh, this has to be very close. Deep mid wicket, deep mid wicket. I'm going to go for a reverse sweep instead with two men behind square on the offside. It wasn't the thinking man's shot. It's been a very fine start from Wisniewski. Well, this is a fine shot down the wicket, smashed over long off, deep extra cover, say what you will, four runs.
Nicely played. Well, just the little deft touch as well coming on the inside line, just what the doctor ordered.
That's clean, sounds good, and it is. Has gone all the way for the maximum here. Dalport flicks the switch.
Well, yeah, nicely bowled because it's exactly where he needed it. And the issue now as well is that it is a no ball, not for a front foot.
Just keep running, Jim. Can't be out of pitching reach inside the circle. I've got to get a couple easy. That run rate's climbed over the eights.
That's it,
straight, nice and clean. Here's another sixer, courtesy of Dalport.
That's it, Denner.
Long handle. Long enough? No.
And from there, he was able to judge the catch. Well flighted as well by Hussain. Excellent bowling. Yeah.
Ring on the offside. Two men behind, inside the circle, behind Lee. Oh, spank you very much. It's up the bank here. It's Zion. Hassan.
And the ball was right in the area where he just swiveled on it. Yeah, good contact. He knew as soon as he hit it. Yeah, he didn't have to run. He is certainly a power hitter before the power play. So, again, two new players, so to speak, out in the middle.
tries to catch it, no one was soaring, let alone try and pick it up and get it in your hands. Moans of the bowl. This has almost gone for six as well. One bounce for four. What a great over there it is. 19 from it. It's 77 for four now. And gone. Yeah, thought it was going a little bit further, Dalport. Early stages of the tournament. It's the surface light. Know what you've got to chase. So there's a little outside edge with Villiers' pace.
Sometimes, from a batting perspective, if you throw your hands at it, you'll still get a good piece of it, a good chunk, and that's exactly what they've done.
Oh, change of pace. And a change result. This has gone all the way. Try to slow on Villiers. Up against Azim Khan. Tried Yorker. And this has gone all the way, folks. Holy heck. A bit of bottom hand punch. Lewis. Big fella gets in the way, but they get two. So they do breach that 100 you're talking about, Lisa Stalaker. They've managed to get up to 104 for five. Have Deccan.
Oh, that's beautifully played over the offside. Has it gone all the way? Oh, it has. It's a glorious stroke from Cadmore.
He's in his area. He just made a subtle little shimmy to the onside and opened that up there nicely.
Yeah, quality batsman. Quality stroke.
Been around the scene for a long time as West Indian. Oh, doesn't matter who you are, what reputation you got. Been laced for four here, Cadmore.
Yeah, not too short from Rampal. He's not quite got the pace he used to have. Watch this. Muscle past mid on. Fine stroke.
God, look at this! The zingers are alive. What a comeback here from Rampal.
Looked like he was waiting to swat another one. Here we go. But it's full. Inside edge, leg stump goes flying, the bales go flying, zinging up the night. He's flying half mast as well with those trousers, expecting floods in Abu Dhabi. Seriously, if anyone has seen the rest of his trousers, if they could give us a call. Oh, this is a big one. Right on a length, beautifully struck through the line from Walton. Wide of long on, that's six of the best.
Wide long on and down on one knee. Just clears that front leg and says, Imran, that's in my slot, buddy.
Enjoyed the gift shop.
Holy moly! Wonderful strike, so Caribbean.
Lovely. So there's this new rolling power play that has been introduced to T10. How do you plan to strategize around that?
Yeah, it's actually
six.
Well, it's interesting because you know it takes. Everyone's always complaining about how difficult the game is, and it's interesting to throw something different with the floating power play because it takes it away from you. I think from that point of view, we're looking forward to see how other teams also use it and utilize it through the tournament.
Real men wear pink, you know that.
Sam. It's going to race away for four behind point. Splendid timing here from Chadwick Walton. Well, risky, but. Yeah, did go there. That's the danger, but that's a cracker. Azim can't take a bow. He does. The big guy. Holy heck.
Well, Karen Pollard take a bow. What a field he set. What a catch by the big man as well. Certainly gobbled that up in the deep. Brilliant knowledge from Pollard. He knew where to put the field up. Look at this, off the line. No problems for the big man.
Oh,
close. Oh, is there a mix-up? Will there be a run-out? Oh, he's thrown the ball to the wrong end.
Hit well, and hit long as well. Niall, that's a big one.
Beautiful bit of timing. Gets himself in a good position. Have a look at this. Nice and still. Picks that bat up and backs himself. Someone has got pace. Often on T10, if you've got pace and you're not quite on the money, you're going to go the distance.
There's a misfield. And that's probably an area that we've noticed already in the first day that hasn't been as sharp as it could be. Well, Lewis goes big. And it's going to clear all of the fielders and the boundary as well. So a big six required, and this is becoming a big over.
Well, we spoke about pace, but look at the pace off the bat. Ken R. Lewis, yeah, commitment to the stroke is good. He knows if he gets half a bat, then it's going to go. In the slot again. Not hitting a good length there. Aaron Summers, and he's getting carted.
Well, this is chipped up and should be taken, yes. Simple catch, wicket required. The Gladiators, and they're able to see the back. Lewis on strike. Oh, slog sweep. Yeah, there's no point running for that. Yeah, he knows he's still got to go hard. Goes for the big pinhole to the leg side. They look to come back for two, and they slipped. But in the end, come back safely. Well, he somehow found a way through. Yeah, well fielded stumpy. That saved a lot of runs. So, end of the eighth over, it's 79 for three.
No value in this, I'm afraid. No value in playing through the V. The previous ball, he tried to hit that same ball through mid-wicket and it went through extra cover for four.
Again, goes for the Yorker and carved through the offside. Again, just over-pitched and absolutely capitalised. Again, full to the stumps. Leg buys this time. No, runs. Got something on it. 16 off 9. He swings and heaves to the leg side. Just what the Pune Devils wanted.
Massive can. Look at this. Oh, you're probably half an inch short of a perfect Yorker. Stick inside edge. Away she scuttles for a boundary.
I think he actually hit that between his legs. Yep. Does he? Slow, but Ken R. Lewis has got a huge piece of that. And it's his 50 as well. What a way to bring it up.
Brilliant. Absolutely fantastic shot. Yeah, why wouldn't you? Get amongst it. That's what that's all about. This is an absolute cracker. His fifth maximum. Well, there was six at the moment left his bat. Little at the side of the hand, slower ball, thank you very much. Easy as you like. 20, 30 yards over the rope.
Short. And that'll do. Only takes two deliveries. And what a victory for Pune Devils. Excellent bowling up front to restrict the Deccan Gladiators to 104. And whilst they probably would have liked to have finished the match a little bit sooner, most important thing is that they get the points and they get the chocolate bickies as well.
You know much about them before this tournament. If you haven't seen them, you know all there is to know now. Absolutely wonderful knock. 57, not out from 28. Six maximums. What a start. What a start for the Pune Devils. Best kid in the comp, and they've got 2 points.
Okay, shots, guys. Stand by.
Oh, match two.